A mighty hand. I'm happy to see you. Place him at the back until I'm ready for him. Just place him at the back. Who come with him? Just place him at the back until you're ready for him. You're so ready to take out that demon out of him. Put him at the back. We know the rain is falling all around the country. So most of our members don't have a car. So they have to stay home, watch the YouTube, watch the TikTok. But I'm happy you have your Range Rover, that's why you're here. You have your BMW, your X6. You're driving in style. You're living in style. You have a happy life. Success. More than enough. Shall be upon you. Hey! Mighty man, you know, An inspector of police called me one day. He said, Pastor, no man no come amongst you and suffer. There is something about you that when someone come among you, something start happening. I command something to start happening for all of you. I start something to start happening. Something mighty, something great, something huge. I say, mighty Kabo Shabbat. Bigger than the universe. Something big is happening. Something huge, something mighty, something strong. Nice. Everywhere you go, you make nice. The weapon of our warfare is not carnal, according to scriptures, but it mighty through Christ for the pulling down of stronghold. Today, our weapon of warfare that God placed upon our life will pull down any stronghold. No matter how strong that mountain is, we are more than a conqueror. Our job is to find a way when there is no way. Our job, our purpose must find a way for victory. Today, the power of God upon your life have already found a way for you. There is a mighty breakthrough for all of you. There is a mighty door open for all of you. There is a mighty increase for all of you. I and you will become a mighty woman and man in this time. We have really persuaded that God have really seen us through. So it's not joke, we're joking. We know He has seen us through. But what is hidden from us must reveal to us. And that's why we're searching. That's why we're searching. Because we know something telling me that there is something great is happening. Something great is happening. And we must found the greatness of God. So they lick you down, you bounce right back. So they lick you down, you bounce right back. So they wounded you, you brush it off, shake it off, get up again. So they wounded you, you brush it off, shake it off, get up again. Never stop trying. 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 There's a woman in Portland. Her father dead and left a old house right at the roadside. And she said, "Prophet, I don't know you. But I watch your videos them and I use your videos them to do what I do. The old house smashed up." And she find a little man that built up a little huge shop. And she buy a bag of bullet, bag of this, bag of that. And put them on the shelf. And the man left her. And she find a next man that opened a next huge shop beside the next shop. I don't know why a man can leave a man so quick. After the man built a huge shop, a man left again. And then for the next one, go on a farm program. Open the next huge shop. So she'd have three shops. She said, she see me. She may have prophesied 12 ladies, so she must open meat shop, grocery shop. And bar. So she opened three shops. And the three man left her, and the shop them empty. She said, "Pastor, me call the call center, tell me sick, couldn't get contact with you. But now me get contact with you. Me know you not gonna leave me. So me want you to stock one of the shop." He said, "All right. Me not know you, you don't know me. And you eat out three men already. So me not make you eat me out." I say, "Open three partner. The partner must run to $500,000. The three partner." She said, "Pastor, you sure?" I say, "Open three partner." That is about 2 months ago. And she go around and advertise with some of the people who have shops in the area, some people in society. They start the partner. Say, "Pastor, me have over 200,000 land." So that's the meat shop. The meat shop is easier to flow than the grocery shop because other grocery shop is in the parish. So I say, "Buy some goat now. Kill a goat, train our fridge, buy some chicken, train our fridge, and start your meat shop. And meanwhile, you are sell, those money that you're making will pay back the partner while he keeps throwing. Just 2 months now." Now she have three fridge, that she got take out a coat soap in the shop. I said, look here, that's the wrong idea. You should not trust nothing. Every time you make money, you buy one fridge, then buy one fridge, then you end up buying two. You know, start making a big money yet. You put yourself in a debt. If nothing now sell, nobody never come to you. It's the pastor. Well, Monday I will sell goat. The man said, give me 5 goats. Five, he said, yeah, feed him done too. There's a Rasta man who leave from Portland come to the Mandeville almost 3 times a month. Get some other goat for him, for her. Now she take a picture and send to me. Her meat shop is more stocked than any big shop in the town. The pastor, you stock my shop and you don't give me no money, but you stock my shop. The bank take your money and build plaza. Build apartments, rings it, and give back trash. And you believe that money that you put in the bank, and they say you must make it stay there for 1 year. It is a, what do you call it? Fixed deposit. When they build the plazas, one of the shop at the plaza is 300,000. 400 toes, 250 toes, that's your money. That's whose money? Your money. And when you do go back, them say, you can't get your money until the year the plaza have been done first. So if most of your business people could open partner, use people money, build yourself, give them back and give them back interest on it. You'll be a better person. You make your bar gone down. Your bar should never go down if it's not selling. Because you have other suggestions that cause money to flow. Put a ninja bike out there and ruffle it. Put a 7-seater van out there and ruffle it. Meanwhile, you don't now sell, you have the ruffling in the meantime. So things always turn over. Come on, man. I'm not here to preach to them, that's just how I talk to you. I'm doing some motivation, business motivation. No preaching. Business motivation, and I'm a little that demon out of a madman. Open a bar, nothing not happening for the bar. The bar is going down. All you need to do is go to the car mart, go to the bike shop, say, sir, I want a 7-seater. You don't have to do a big thing right now, for you know your bar is small. I want a 7-seater. 7-seater, maybe $1.7 million. I want you to put it at my bar. I will pay you for the 7-seater in 6 months. They will take the thing. So they pack it up with plastic, pretty like pretty poop. I mean, no ugly thing. You need something to attract people's eyes. You pack it up right at your bar and you start ruffle it at $1,000 per ticket. Ruffle it for 6 months. By Christmas, they want to win it for Christmas, for the Christmas present. Then you put a big ninja bike right there and ruffle it. But you know the bike can sell maybe $700,000, $500,000. So you can ruffle it for $500. You put it right there. So you're ruffling the two things at the same time. The first month, I can promise you, you're going over $10 million. Roughly. You pay for the van more than 10 times, and in 6 months you commit. You can open meat shop, wholesale, whatever. And because you make so much money, nobody grown the people, they make somebody win it. When you see Christmas come, just roughly make them win it. You don't make millions or you can open a business. You start build plaza now. Start build bookstores. Find what taking the and open what taking the market. It's not everywhere you can open a shop because too much shop is there. It's not everywhere you can open a meat shop because too much meat shop is there. It's not everywhere you can open a bar because too much bar is there. Find things that desires people. Some places you don't have no ice cream shop. Ice cream and cake shop and those stuff. Open one day. Some places you don't have no jerk shop. Open one day. Some places you don't have no barber shop, no salon. Open one day. But do not put your heart under one lever. Put your heart in many levels. Even the curry shop is small, split it in a two. Meat shop, grocery shop, bar, restaurant. So you have multiple income coming in. And while multiple income coming in, you're doing raffling at the same time. Someone will win. You can raffle more than one different vehicles. So you have people that run down your thing. And try your very best make somebody in that district where you live win it. So everybody in that ear can say, boy, I miss Pam. When you van down, you say, no, we want to win next year. So people in the parish realize that it's Miss Pam, son down the road did win the van. So they might want to win again. You with me, somebody? Everything about life is good and bad. Any pastor, any prophet, any apostle, any one of them said they are righteous in the sight of God. They are liar. Everyone have to do bad things to survive. Everyone have to have bad intention to survive. If you have all good intention, you will never survive in Jamaica. A doctor go to university, borrow maybe $3-4 million, get his degree, his diploma, his PhD, and become a doctor. Open his doctor office. What do you think he do? He go and open his Bible. He said, God, you forgive me first before me talk. Make people sick and become yourself. Walk from the room and see people walk up and down healthy and strong. He said, Lord, them two is strong, man. Take me card. I sick you when you sick, you take sick. Take me card. I take sick, you come to me. You think he's praying for everybody to be healthy? He would die for hunger. He have to have bad intention. God sick them. So you come to me after and give him some tablet. Pastor, we are holy, we are righteous. No, you're not righteous people. You're wrong door too. The restaurant is praying for people to get hungry. So you have to come buy food. You think you can pray God, make everybody be filled, make everybody be happy? No. I want them to hungry and tormented. I want them to come to my shop so I sell food and have money. The mechanic prays, the Lord, make it people them care broke down. So make him have care of the fix. You think the mechanic is so righteous as a God, make people them care and broke down? His child couldn't go to school. He wouldn't have no food on his table. So he have to pray, Lord, send rain. Wash out some of them engine. Burn up some of them radiator. But them have to come and me fix it for them. So I can have food on my table. You think these men who fix cars want the government to fix the road? No. Make the road stay, make the car them mash up. Mash up the front end parts. So then come and we take them off and replace them back. That's how we get job. That's how we have money. Talk to me, no man. When you come on to the church now, let me see. The church now. You think your pastor got prayed, everybody be healthy and strong? No. Oh, but some of them make them come to prophet row. Let me deliver them. So else when them belly they come to prophet row. Let me deliver them. When you pray like that, but if all of you have jobs, all of you healthy, all of you strong, you don't need me. Make some of them turn fool and know if you do, they come to me. That's how life is. The shoes man said, God, make rain fall, make their shoes pop out. But they have to come and me suffer shoes. Then now, as a doctor, him link up with his lab friend. His lab friend link up with his next friend. Link up with the next friend. So you go there now, you have little gas in him, and gas can give little lump. And him say, no man, no, I'm saying too much. He give you one paper. I'm friend lab, you know. Go longer the lab at the. They're very good. You go down there, you know, said 30% of the money for him. Yes. Then he send you back. He have an next friend at Kingston. He said, we have to do further tests. Go Kingston. 35,000 again. You know, said 15,000 for him. Then you come back, reply, he said, okay. I'm seeing a sis. You have to do CT scan again, go down, friend, again, and you give your wife again. After I'm done milk you for 3 months straight, he say, the medication that I give you, let it reduce. It'll reduce. No, never did it. The man say it'll reduce. Never. You say, if you keep on taking medication, it will disappear by itself. 2 more months you go back, him say gone. You spend over 300,000 already when nothing never did it. That's how they work. If you're not smart, you do tests and tap a test and tap a test and tap a test. And next thing now, because I go back to my business, but next thing. For my informant now. You must do a little blood test. One drop of your blood into the machine and you can tell them what happened to your blood. You take 13 buckle of blood. Have already signed a contract with the blood bank, you know, that the amount of blood you bring to the bank, the amount of money you get. The poor little innocent darling, 13 buckle of blood. Them realize that she's sick and she might soon dead. Them take 7 more buckle of blood and leak out her blood before she dead. So the auntie go there and say, so she take 13 buckle out from her last week. We to take 7 more buckle. We have to send them to lab. Lab only want one little job. And send gone. And Jamaican people pass full. Cocoa head. Peanut head. No, may I put on back on the head? You trained for 7 years as a doctor. If I tell you that I have a stick at my side, you must know what it is. He's a doctor. You don't have to send me to do no bag of tests to know, because you're a doctor, you must know. If my head that hurt me and it upon me, you should know, say a sinus upon me. If it hurt me but it not upon me, you must know, say I just brain headache me out. So Jamaican people need wisdom.
Right.
Knowledge. Understanding. It's like this. I grew up seeing my grandma mix lime and blue and wash out the place. Me do the same thing too. Now I grew up and realize the lime and blue bring crosses. Once you use lime and blue to wash out your house, your wife must leave you. Once you use lime and blue to wash off yourself, your wife or your woman or your husband will walk out. Once you use lime and blue to wash out your shop, that shop after a while got right down. And who sell it? The Chinaman. Tell me which Chinaman you ever see I use lime and blue to wash out your shop? Not even one. That's why you as black man have it. So you not sell and them sell. Y'all learn now? You have some internet cafe. Take some pictures of pretty horses. Write a little nice sub, make somebody laugh. And write it right down here. With the horses up here. Hey, look up nice night. And sell it 1,000 for your pluck. While you print it at the cafe, you can go to the bookstore and buy a little frame like this. And drop it nice. Sell it for 2,500. Go to Devon House and take pictures of butterflies with birds at the flowers. Put it in the pluck. And sell it for $2,000. Go to the gift shop. The gift shop have some nice words in the gift that they have there. The gift cards. Take your little phone and take pictures of the words. Atifi, atifi. Write your name across my heart. Just those things in writing it. And you take pictures of them. When you go home, you type up what you see. Put it back in, just mix it up, put it back in your own words, and put it on your plaque. Now go sell. And stop, sit down a yard, sit down and go on. Stop, sit down at home, sit down and go on. All you have to do is go to a bookstore and ask the manager, I want to drop off 50 pluck at one of your shelf. When it is mine, 10 is yours. They say, what? Put them there. Yeah. Every month you go collect. You're afraid if you know, she say, okay, they're selling, so guess what? I'm gonna pay you for them on the spot. You just bring them, I pay on the spot, because they're selling. And you go to 5, 6, or 7 different bookstores. And drop off your pluck. You know when they decide now, them realize you think I sell, then give a shelf for yourself. Buy some Malta. Buy red wine. And buy Campari. Mix your red wine, the malt, and the Campari. Show it now on next buckle and put your label on it and go sell. Your liquor. You sell more than even Jerry and Navy. Why? Because you mix it already and it bam! People say, where this come from? It's smoothie? Malta. Campari. And red wine. Very smooth. And just put your blend on it. Just mix them up together. You're taking people vision, build yours because you can't find yours. Stop, sit down at home. say no, no, go on, and time tough. If you cannot survive because you don't know your purpose, take people purpose and build yours. You have some eye sheen products and some hair products that take in the market. Buy those eye sheen products and those hair products and put little castor oil in it. We grow people here thicker and faster and mix them together and drop it in a hair buckle. Put your labor point and go sell. You do not have to walk up and down and sell. All you have to do is make the first 50 and go at the store that they sell the hair products and present your products and they buy it from you. Put it on the shelf. If you want to push them, you can say, we will deliver 50 bucks for you to you and you pay us every month. The more ease they get from you. And because it grow the hair fast and it smell very nice, people start to rush it. You realize that you start making money now, you employ 5 or you employ 10 sissy. What did I say, look well? You employ 10 sissy. 10 sissy have 1 or 2 buckle of the hair plugs in them bag. And then start take bus and start walk and talk about your products. And them drive go mobile upon bus. When you go mobile, them come off, then take a bus called Negril, them talk about it, then come off, then take a bus from Negril, go south, then come off, then take a bus from south, go Santa Cruz, then come off till night I come, then go home. Just go around the parish. And I tell people things on the bus about your products. People want to buy immediately. These products kill dandruff, thicken your hair and grow your hair faster. Destroy dry cells. People want to buy your products. So how is the time tough? You just need mentor. Bring your dark eyes to me. Bring your eyeglass to me. Come here, this one. Come. Some people just want a little hype. Go sit on your seat, mama. You have some person, once they come out and look up in the sun, it kind of make them feel a little dark or make them eyes feel away. So you go to the stores that sell the glasses and buy out every glasses. Go to the tilt man and make a tilt man tilt some dark, some kind of dark, some shiny dark, some blue dark, and sell. When you look on your store, you have over 300 glasses. And people just want the glasses to take the sun off their eyes. Then you have some glasses that make them look a bit brighter. They want to see brighter, but they also want to look a bit shady. The tilt man just tilt. You can tilt yourself too. Just buy the tilt and use a razor, cut it and tilt yourself. What is the time tough? I'm not tough. Are you tough? Time is not hard if you have wisdom. Is you hard? I'm giving you a career. Thank you. very important in life that you understand the signs of the time. If you easily get angry, easily get bitter, easily get cross, it's because your head is too full. You need a release. Once your head gets back light, you can sit down and talk to somebody for hours and you don't get angry. But once your head is heavy because that is up there, as someone talk to you, you trigger. The least little thing trigger you up. So please, my people, get up here to light. I don't know how you're going to do it, because some of you don't have nobody, but you have to go find a way. Maybe you and your shower will help, but you have to go find a way. I go deeper. Look at me, all of you. And this is reality. This is reality. Everything upon the earth comes from the earth, isn't it? It plants. The signs of the time flows. The sun removes out of the mystery, out of a secret place, at a certain time in the morning. 4:30 coming to 5 o'clock, the mouth of the earth open to release life upon the earth. And the mouth of life move, and the sun release out of the mystery and appear upon the earth. 4:30 coming to 5 o'clock. 4:30 coming to 5 o'clock, you must get a bottle of honey. Write your name, write what you want in the buckle of the honey, open the buckle of the honey, and plant it at a root of a tree that bear the most. Your life is now in the sweetest thing on the earth, honey. Something that never spoil, but it lasts forever. Your name, your children name, your family name, your husband, never say I tell anybody, a power may I tell you. And you plant it under that mango tree or that pear tree or any tree that bear the most. And just like how the tree bear, so your life and your children them start to bear. It must be 4:30 coming to 6 o'clock. No. If you plant peas, corn, anything you plant, it start to pop up by 4:35, 6 o'clock. So when you wake up in the morning, you say, wow, it come out of ground already. It pop up. The mystery of life pop up 4:30 to 6 o'clock. Pop up. Times of life appears. The mouth of the earth continues to stay open to release life from 6 o'clock coming to 11:30 in the day. The signs of the time is everywhere. Your shadow start to go in front of you to show you your step is ordered by God. Yes. 11:30 going to 12 o'clock. Your shadow start to rush underneath your feet and lock to tell you pestilence is passing at noonday. Destruction, torment, crosses. The mouth of the earth flows immediately and your shadow lock your feet to tell you be still and know there's God. Amen. To go into 1 o'clock, the mouth of earth start to open and your shadow start to go beside you. To tell you, things have changed. Going from 3:30 up to 6 o'clock, your shadows start to to tell you, don't trust no shadow. A After 6 o'clock in the evening, the mouth of the earth closed and hand over to pestilent by night. Fallen angels, that people that say there is wishing stars, they're not wishing stars, they're fallen angels, they're principalities and darkness in high places. They start to run down, and you see running stars, they're not running stars, they are principalities and power. Be careful how you wish. Come down by night, running demons come down by night to torment human race. Every cars that they can crash, they crash. Every truck that they can run off the road, they run off the road. Be careful how you walk by night. Very important. Life is a mystery. If you have a doubt about someone, don't be a part of the life, because you must 100% sure it is well. I don't know how may I sweat so. Come like me want help too. But it's all right. Me find a way. Bishop, me find a way. Me, I'm me a teacher, so me must know the way. Doctors have no medication to release your head or to detox your brain. So for to detox your brain, you have to wait until the rain starts to fall. You take off your shoes and go out in the rain and you catch cold. When you catch cold, all the clover and sinus that cluster your brain will start running through your nose. And in 2 or 3 weeks, you may suffer for a while, but it's detoxing your brain. After 2 or 3 weeks, all the clover run out, you detox your brain, and your eyesight come back, your nature come back, and your life is strong again. If you live for 1 year and you don't catch cold, to blow your nose is a sign that you're soon dead. You must detox your brain. When you eat, you must pass out. When you drink, you must pass out. When you live, you must pass out. That's why you have 2 holes to blow them out. Feel weak, always feel nauseous is a sign that your zinc cells need to reprogram your body. To reprogram your body, you have to let your foot stay at certain temperature. So you have to dig the earth, especially when rain is falling. You dig the earth, throw some water in the earth, take off your shoes and make your foot a little bit warm. You can have on your shoes for the whole day. After you take off your shoes, you put your foot right in the water in the earth for 1 hour. The radiation of the earth start to flow straight to your body. You must anoint your foot with honey so the radiation take time to flow to your body in everlasting. If you take off your shoes and put your foot on the earth without put honey, the virtue of the earth will flow to your body to reprogram your body, and all of a sudden you start to sneeze because they move too fast. It must go at a certain speed. You understand me? So put honey underneath your feet, take off your shoes, put honey underneath your feet, place it on the ground, and virtue start to go right to your body and reprogram your cells there. And all of a sudden, whatever in your body, you start use a bathroom, your belly start run. Everything run out. The earth do that to you. That's why people used to live for 200 years, 300 years, 1,000 years in the past, because they don't wear shoes. They connect with power. So the power detox the body, reprogram the body, and they live. Now for 2 years, you don't put your foot on the ground. As you come out of the bed, you depend on carpet, you're in your slippers, you're in your shoes, so the earth don't get the time to reprogram your body. That's why you're so sicky. Sometimes you must walk barefoot. Go outside, walk barefoot. Give the earth some time to make nature come to your body. Reprogram yourselves then. Sometimes you must wet up in the rain. Get a rain bath. Pastor, what? You're a country girl. You know, I make a lot of problems in the country. That's why I stop prophesying straight. There's a lady, she bring her sister here. She have a supermarket in Montego Bay. And she never help her sister. But they come in here with her husband and buy buck up. The sister come in the vehicle with them. So I told the sister, I said, I'm gonna make you be a billionaire this year. Put a little smile on her face. I sent her to a car mart that I know in Montego Bay. Hope they watch the video after we done this. And I tell her to get a HRV, you know the HRV? 2018 HRV. I tell a gentleman, give her, put it at her sister supermarket and let them raffle it. The sister was so happy because she believed that people come to buy her to a supermarket. It's not that. I want your sister to run past you to realize that she's a sister. So they place the HRV in pretty in plastic and roughly $1,000 per ticket. The first week she make over $3 million. And Saturday, the sister tell her to move bigger from her place. The sister want to collect the money, collect the ticket, and I give her a strong instruction. Let the caremat man keep the money. So when it finished pay, the caremat man take free money and give you a lift. The sister session now works, brother. As she bring her come my church, but I know for your prophecy. Are your sister prophecy? They make over $18 million. All the caramat man thieves of my money. But he take a pay for the vehicle, give her back the rest, and now she have her own wholesale. Run past the person who bring her. So you be careful who you bring here. Up till to the day, but she called me last week. She just sits and I talk to her. From the raffle start, and she start make money. She sits that on her enemy. They gonna love you because they're a little bit higher than you. But when you start run past them, problem. So they have it, we say, because of Prophet Ro, your two sisters not talk. Not because of me, but because of bad mind. Can't stand to see your sister making millions beside you. Bad mind. People today who come to this church, they will never bring their friend. Afraid that Prophet Ro will prophesy and clear their friend, and their friend run past them. Wicked. Wicked. You must, if your dog sick, bring a dog home. There's a lady from Brownstone said, "Pastor, I will never bring my husband at your church. He love you, he watch your show, but me not bring him, because I don't want him to get no blessing past me." She alone wants to control. She alone wants to control. My people, all of you who you know something right at the yard where you live. From your walk to your gate, you just know something right. Get one of Prophet Raw Sugar and sprinkle it through your yard. Get one of Prophet Raw honey. Mix it in some water and dash it through your yard. If you and your husband or your fiancé or babe mother, whosoever you're in love with, now live good, boil some warm water. Listen, power. Boil some warm water. Put honey till it's sweet in that warm water. And put in our bathroom and he turn a beard from head to toe tonight. Hallelujah. You call it honey bath. The sweetness come back immediately. Everlasting power. If you have a baby father that's not taking care of a child, you do the same thing. And his power that connects with God come right back to you. Everlasting. You have some liquid things that can cause a mighty thing in your life. You just don't know. They don't know that you couldn't go into work, everything going on, and you buy one bathing soap, and that bathing soap curse and you lose a job. Do not use the same bathing soap every day. If you use carbolic today and this week no go on good, don't use it next week. You use lock this week and it no go on so good, don't use it next week. Until you use a soap that the whole week go good, use that one. You don't know what they use to make this soap. So don't just give up and use soap, use soap. Choose one that cause your week to be great. Attraction is very important. Things that attach to you is very important. If every day crass is attached to you, something about the life no good. As you take up the woman, you almost crush, you punch her. Tell her to come out and you rastafari bust a man to kill. As you take up the man, your light cut off. Your landlord give you notice. Buy two lighter. When you see him come, light it. Fire! Sometimes some crass is just stepping in your life. And you follow you straight back until you get rid of it, you'll never prosper. Very important in life. that you make observations of your steps. If this a foot not firm, do not move this foot. You know why some of you have heartbreak? You're going to want a relationship two way. No. One foot of mama yard, one foot of fame yard. If it not work, you foot come back yourself. So now and again, me sleep on mama, me go there so, me sleep on mama. So me depend on your borderline. But no, you take your whole of your clothes them, the whole of your shoes them, the whole of your Rastafari them, and you go and pack up. When you say come out, you can't go back to mama for mama. For your born mama. Yeah, if you have a look for a friend. No. Me the between mama and you. By the line. So if me eat, mama eat. If me not eat, my mama must still eat. A real man will not let mama suffer while him woman eat. Until mama start eat, you can't eat. Bring him come a film time. Come a year time. Deserve the glory. Do you learn something today? Yeah. Put that tray here and put him there. Morning wine.
Thank you.
there is a young girl here. You're into a relationship. And from the day you enter the relationship, there's a sore come on your feet. And your feet start to sore many places. I want to pray for you. I want to pray for you. Yeah, I'll come back. Now, yes, sir. Yeah, I'll come back. From the day you enter the relationship, there's a sore come on your feet. We're in your body. They scratch all over. There used to be a married man, Eronio. Where is he now? Disappear. Where's your passport? You say you don't have a passport? Not even have a birth certificate? Brother Benny. Brother Bernard. Two more minutes. You're young. You're brilliant. You're going very far in society. The government make it very easy for you to get a new register passport and also birth paper. So I'm going to release you. Let them take your number so we can get your passport and your birth paper for you. You understand me? Where is your fiancé? You left him? So you left him, no problem. We're going to shape you up now, fix you up. You're going to get ginger, busy, and garlic, and drink it for your tea for 15 morning. It reduces the fat in your belly, give you make your belly flat like mine. After the 15 morning over, you come to us, we give you morning wine and noni, and you flat it out more. Then we get your passport, your birth paper, and set back your life on track again. Where is Mama? I destroy every spell on your mother. I destroy every spell on your family. I destroy every spell that taking control over your life. I command you to the brightest child in the classroom. I cause favor to be upon you. Favor. I command you to be great. Go home. Sing praises. Take off everything.
Everything?
Everything. Take off mine. Take off the name. Everything.
Ah, brother, ah. Wait, Alex. Alex, see you too. Yeah. No. Abdul, I'm afraid of it.
We don't like car, no.
Never accident.
Next night, it's a fight car.
How much are you come?
Three.
Three?
So write up yourself.
Idiot. Me ask you how much are you?
Four.
How much?
Four.
You just said three. How much are you? Fire! How much are you?
Fire!
Why you hold her down?
Fire!
Why you stop her promotion?
What are you? Four. Fire!
Why you want to kill her? Why you want to kill her?
Too much ambition.
Much?
Too much ambition, sir.
Who will send you? Who will send you? What's your name? Name?
Peter Gay.
Peter Gay, send you? Somebody. So Peter Gay is close to her fiancé. And what you say? Open your eyes, yeah. Open your eyes, yeah. Tell Prophet Row one more lines to warm to you. Think you can trick me? Fire!
Fire!
Who will send you? I don't tell me no lie. Who will send you? Who will send you?
Fiancé.
Fiancé send you? Why her fiancé working on her?
I don't want her to leave.
Hmm?
I don't want her to leave him. If you are hiding and hiding.
Oh, so hide the ID and the passport them. Can't find the ID them.
Fire!
No one should leave him.
No one should leave him.
17 years a man, the crown should never want him.
17 years.
Fire!
How much are you say come?
Four.
Four? So what do you tell her if you do?
Mash up her life.
Mash up her life. What and what to do to her? You hold her down?
Fire!
You mash up her foot? Her foot will torment. So you mash her up? And you want her to kill herself? So every night, you go to her if you hang herself in. And she make attempt to hang herself and her great grandma protect her. Hmm? So her grandma protect her. That's why you don't kill her yet.
Fire!
Hmm?
She girl is full of ambition. Rubber she gonna bad no like her, she full of too much ambition.
Fire!
Buy up your furniture.
No worry for me.
Fire!
Buy furniture.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well. Mm-hmm.
Your head full of fire now. Full of fire now.
Fire!
The fire now.
Fire!
Come out. Fire! Come out. Fire! Come out. How much leave? How much you leave?
Fire!
Fire! Come out. Fire! Come out. You must leave her. Fire! Break every chain. Come out. Fire! Come out. Fire! Come out. Fire! Come out. Fire! Take your flight. Fire!
Thank you.
Come, Mama. Come, Mama. How long he is like this?
Long time.
Oh, old is now, son?
27.
Yeah, 27. 11 years of your life you're buried. Buried on the mango tree. No doctor help you. No pastor help you. No one help you. Take off your shirt. Bring me a shirt. Levy years of torment. Levy years of crosses. We say look well. Eh? Now come on. So they give you a date when you should kill her. When was the date? From March you should kill her. 21 of March. So in great grandmother protect her. That's why you not kill her yet. So you should kill her from March, the 20, the 21 of March. You kill his son. You kill three of the brother them. Murder them. And if you kill she.
She's so powerful, we can't kill her. So make people just hate her.
Hold on.
She's nice, you know, a nice girl.
Hold on, you idiot. You kill three brother.
Kill
your son 2020. And you kill his son 2020.
Can't kill her.
And they said to kill her 2023. So she should die the 21st of March. But her great grandmother might protect her. That's why you can't kill her. So how much are you leave?
Two
leave. So who me touch little while? Who me touch little while? Who this? Who this? Who?
Akula.
I cooler this.
Akula.
Akula. So who this? Who this? Who? Who this?
Yeah?
Where name? Where name?
A curse.
Whisper, yeah. Fire!
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 The time is up now. You killed four persons here from there already.
Mash up all the knees.
All the knees, you mash up. Where knees name? Chudian. So you mash up Chudian too. So where all of you come from? All of you who must be from, where you come from?
Africa.
Africa. Me not like Africa. Fire! Come out! Fire! Come out! Fire! 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 Come out! Fire! Come out! Fire! Come out! Fire! 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 Go back. Fire! 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 Fire!
Fire! Fire!
Sola. 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 Come up now. Eleven years of your life. You're suffering until now. Your suffering is over. Raise all your family. Where is all your family? Hug mama. Hug mama. Go home. If you talk one more time, we tie you back. Lie down. Lie down now. Relax. No more talking. Come here, Cinderella. Come here. Now come on. You say you're convicular, don't it? Come here. You say you're convicular. Open your eyes and look at me. Open your eyes and look at me.
So the last one for your mother and mother love her.
Open your eyes and look at me. What you see? You see power? What you see? Open your eyes. What you see?
Power.
See power?
She come here, Father.
Open your eyes again. Come out now.
She have too much ambition. Look, things she have on my
stomach. She gonna build more house. She gonna build more house. She gonna build more house. She gonna take plane like taxi and she gonna marry now. And now she gonna marry.
What you come here for?
Depend you know.
You make sure get back nurse job. Girl's brilliant and bright. When she go to work at night time, we look on her shoes, we watch her.
Fire! Come up.
And in the workplace,
fire! Fire! Come up. Fire! Come up. Fire! Come up. Fire! Come up.
What's she come here for?
Fire! Come up. Fire! Come up. Fire! Come up. Fire! 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 How much leave? Much? The next two gone. Who talking to me?
Separator.
Yes. Your name separation.
Work on it just a glass. Every glass in the house mash up.
I don't see a separation, your name. How long now you're dead? Who kill you?
Gunman.
Gunman kill you. Where did name when you're alive?
Junior
what?
Skeng.
Junior Skeng. Where them bury you? Dove cut them bury you.
Hello.
So you say when you was alive your name is Ken. Junior Ken. Who was your mother? Who was your mama?
Rena Edwards.
Where's Ken used to live?
Waterhouse.
So who kills Ken?
Gunman is come from which was living.
So gunman shoot him at Waterhouse. And then bury my dove cut. Yes, sir?
No people have been unfamiliar and I don't want to live. No people have talked to some people, brother.
No. You don't talk that, but me ask you some questions, man. So when you got dove cut, how you come out of your grave?
Raise me up.
Who raised you?
Some revivalist.
Some revival people just take you out of your grave.
Coconut
and water. And take you out of your grave. And send you to work. So how much person you kill already? You kill half our family them. Four of them you kill already.
My brother, she can't find my brother.
Which part
kill
of brother?
Him.
Which part then kill him?
Walter
House. Where them hide him?
Everyone
grown. So them just kill him and bury him. Which part of Walter House? Where him name?
Winston Williams.
In knees down there. Which part of water? Which part of water was the dead body there?
Over the gully side.
Over the gully side. Which part of the gully side?
Beside the bridge.
Beside the bridge, then bury him. And then you find him all now.
And the man came straight away. Go to my kitchen and kill him. And I find my brother. I shot the family.
So you say, you do it, you do all of them something. So who will tell, who will send you for do all them something?
People don't want to do that.
So as a day man, when you work for them, how you get reward?
Do the work.
What them give you?
Money.
What type of money?
Need money.
But you're a day man, you don't have no use of money.
Other man.
Eh?
Man get money.
Or the other man get the money. So you don't get nothing.
So you work.
But you have to do the work. Or else them burn you. So you work for nothing. You look like you're an idiot then. Alright. So come here man, we want some information from you. Who else you know then kill and bury? We can't find anybody. Who else? Who else you know? Where's your name?
Nadine.
What?
Nadine.
Which part them barrier?
Same place over the gully.
Nah, gully.
Over the gully, but the
land. Who kill her?
Gunman.
You know your gunman them?
I know gunman them.
And they already. So, a whole lot of people bury over the gully.
Yeah, anybody touch your family, then they don't know where to touch them from. Anybody touch your family, then they don't know where to touch them from.
Hold on a man, hold on a man. So Nadine bury over the gully. How long now?
She not come from the area.
She not come from the area. But then bury over the gully. Mm-hmm. Nadine, what's your name?
Green.
Nadine what?
Green.
Nadine Gray.
Green. Nadine.
Oh, Green. Nadine Green. Where she did come from?
She come from
Green
Park.
Park she come from? Oh, so she had a boyfriend in the water house?
Yeah.
So her boyfriend helped kill her?
Mm-hmm.
You lied to me, you know. You look like you lied to, you know. So them bury a lot of dead people in the gully.
The gully bank.
Describe the gully bank we are talk. What is your name?
Big gully in the water house, my God, the gully bank.
What is your name?
Sandy Gully.
Sandy Gully? Oh. And sometimes they wash out nights on the water.
Oh.
Eh?
Most people don't want to know where they are. I don't want to talk too much.
You want to talk too much? Enough people know her. So how much are you leaving in this body now? So how you enter this body?
So, jealous of her.
So
jealous.
How you go in her body that I'm talking? How you get to go inside her body? Or get melon.
Yes.
And when she eat a melon, you just
go. Head start hurt her.
Head start hurt her. And just go in her back. Oh. Oh. So you get her melon.
And
when she eat a melon, just go in her.
Oh.
And head start hurt her. She helped them too.
Stop helping people. She helped too much people.
You know, it's a prophet who will take you out now, don't you?
Watch how she live.
Let her go.
Girl, you're a hype girl. Three car, you mash up fear already, now I want to tell you.
Three car, you mash up fear? Mash them up.
I'm not going to care, I'm going to sell them.
Have you sell them?
Mash up our lives, man.
Every day, Karen broke down.
Every day, she's rich, you know. What money she hold?
Fire!
Hold her back.
Fire! Don't touch her. Come out. Fire! Fire!
come here, fire.
Fire! Come out. Come out. Fire! Fire! Come out. Fire! Come out. Fire! Red knees, knees come. Come knees. How much do you leave now? One? One leave? Come here. One leave? One leave now? Today you shall come out.
Mash them up!
Come out now. Come out now. Fire! Come out. Fire! Come out. Fire! Out. Fire! 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 Raise your knees. Come out to her. Fire! Come out to her. Fire! Come out. Fire! Come out. Fire! Come out. Fire! Come out to her. Fire! Come out. Fire! Come out. Come out. Fire! Come out. How much leave? How much leave? How much leave? Take your flight. Take your flight. Take your flight. Take your flight. Stop, touch them. Today you're free. Today you're free. Come back here. Through the power of the divine. 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 Come to me. Come to me. Lift her up and bring her. Come. Come with the chair. Just lift up the chair. Lift up the chair with her and come. Come. Today you're free. Through the power of the divine. Free. 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 Kibabo Sada Baba Santa. Go home. Take her up. Sit down. Go home. You're free. For doctor Sarah with your feet.
Arthritis.
No. I'm gonna touch it, it's gonna hurt a little. You feel it?
Yes.
It's gonna hurt again. You're gonna hurt. Calabaza! Don't worry. Don't worry, it's coming out. It's coming out. It's coming out. Fire! 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 You soon get up now. It's a sowing day today. I want all of you to put your bag on the altar. After I pray for this person. Yeah, soldier. Take a... You want to be a soldier?
No.
What do you want to become?
Nurse.
You want to become a nurse? Seeing a little girl into an eggshell and the egg break, and then I don't see the girl again. You have a 15-year-old daughter, not that one. I'm seeing one after the 15-year-old. And then to two hands. Blessing never stop follow you. Do good. Go home. Where is your husband? Where is your husband? He died now. What happened to him? What happened to him? He's in Portland. Come to me. You don't have arthritis. They bury a ram goat skull where you live with your picture in the ram goat head. Just remove it. Rasta, come here, Ras. Who buy your soda?
I'm a grandson. My mother's grandson.
Your head come back now?
Yeah, ma'am.
Salute.
Salute.
All right. Sleep, just sit down. There is a young girl here. Every time you do something with your fiance, you feel the pain and you feel some movements. Come, let me pray quickly. So you feel the wiggling like a snake. And it also goes straight there. Get me a glow. When you go home, bed, after your bed, you use this and spray the promised land. Love, mix up. Close in 1 minute. Everyone get your bags put on the altar. Just put it on the altar for 5 seconds, then take it up.
Hello.
Do not leave the bag, just put it on for 5 seconds, then take it back up. Open it, let me spray. Just open it. Just open the bag so I can spray it.
Some are finding mercy, forgiveness for their sins. Some are fighting battles and they're struggling. Time has come to give them to the Lord. That's what this altar is for. That's what this altar is for. And you don't have to carry those burdens anymore. There's a light in the darkness. There's a love that's true. And Jesus is waiting. He is waiting here for you. Go quickly now before they close the door. That's what this altar is for. Son, a mother kneels beside them, thanking God they've come. An old man is standing there in tears, giving up a part of him that he's held back for years. Hearts are being broken. Lives are being changed. Those who call upon him, they will never be the same. The time has come to give in to the Lord. That's what this altar is for. That's what this altar is for. You don't have to carry those burdens anymore. There's a light in the darkness. There's a love that's true. Jesus is waiting, he is waiting here for you. Go quickly now, before they close the door.
Said, I am blessed and highly favored.
I am blessed and highly favored.
I am great.
I am great.
I am wonderful. I am awesome through the eye that I am.